Diamond and Silk. Ladies, good afternoon.
Hi.
Hi.
Good afternoon.
How are you? You heard me introduce our guest coming up at the bottom of this hour, African-American conservative woman. But it ain't easy to be those things, is it?
Well, you know, sometimes it's not because the left just wants you to stay in a box. So I'm happy to see the involvement of conservative. Well, she may have already been a conservative, but I'm just happy to see conservative black women.
That's right. I absolutely love it. That's what we call a triple threat.
Yeah.
Black, she's a woman, and she's conservative.
That's right.
You know, I called her dangerous, but it really is in terms of the existence of the Democratic Party for everything that they have sort of created for themselves in identity politics and the policies that try to sort of fuel those politics that they've been able to succeed with. If African-American women start rising up and saying, you know what, we don't fit into that mold anymore, then what are the Democrats standing for anymore?
Absolutely. And you see African-American women rising up today, mm-hmm. and saying, hey, we don't fit in that mold anymore. We can think for ourselves. We can become free thinkers. We are free thinkers. And if you see some on the left are attacking them. Mm-hmm. But here is the deal.
What's the deal?
We don't need them spoon-feeding us a narrative. Mm-hmm. We can think for ourselves, and we can think outside of the box. And if we choose to think conservative, be conservative, we can do that as black people. So I love it.
Ladies, you know, listen, what you do on YouTube and with your chit chat lives and everything that you do on your website and on social media, it couldn't be more different than what Alex Jones does with his performance art. And I'm not trying to make any kind of equation between the two, other than the fact that Jones is in the news right now because he's getting shut out. He's getting clamped down by these big digital media companies saying you don't meet our standards. Well, you've had experience with that sort of thing.
We've been telling people what was going on for a long time.
Yeah, you have. But
Alex Jones has experienced what we call a political lynching. They choked him out from up under his platform, just mm-hmm. took it away from him,
right.
and left him riding dirty. That's just what it is. You know, back in the day, and I'll say it and say it again, what we're living in is the new, what I call Jim Crow days, orchestrated by the left.
Mm-hmm.
See, back in the day, they used to discriminate against you based on the color of your skin. Today, they are discriminating against you based on the color of your politics. And when we see what's happening to Alex Jones, who is a commentator that speaks his opinion, and they're telling him, well, you don't meet what we allow on our platform.
Uh-huh.
That's the problem for us, because what you're doing is stifling his free speech. And why are you stifling his free speech? What did he do? What did he say? Now, they're not the arbitrator of truth, but it looked like CNN, and I don't know if I can call the call letters or the very fake news, is trying to orchestrate and arbitrate who do what when it comes to these platforms. Yet they are the one that spread conspiracy theories all the time, every day, all day.
That's
but
right.
They don't shut them down.
Yeah,
we just turn a channel.
Listen, we have freedoms in this country.
Mm-hmm.
We have a right to free speech, and we have a right, if we don't like what somebody is saying, we turn the channel. If you don't like what Alex Jones is saying, turn somewhere else. But to take his whole platform and pull it from up underneath him, yes, that was a political lynching. We're living in the Jim Crow days, orchestrated by the left.
Well, this is a good chance to ask you, do you have resolution with Facebook, with the other social media platforms that you use, with YouTube? Are you still seeing this kind of nefarious actions, the shadow banning that they've been doing, or are things sort of mellowed out now for you?
Listen, it's still there. It's the shadow banning. It's the stifling of free speech. Our content is not being seen.
Yeah.
People are not, we're not coming up in their news feed. Yet they continue to apologize. It's the same old, it's like stabbing the knife in your back and twisting it to bring you down while they apologizing to you. So you can't accept those kind of apologies. And see, here's the deal. They don't get to pull out their censorship bully whip and think they can whip us back into silence because they don't like the fact that we're very patriotic and we love this country. They don't get to do that.
Well, and meanwhile, I'm sure you saw this new New York Times editorial board member who was saying all these things about white people on Twitter, right? And she's not only celebrated and allowed to do that, she's elevated and promoted to the New York Times.
I saw that. Let me tell you what outraged me. So that happened, but we had another young lady who happened to be a black woman that took that Asian girl tweets, took the same tweets, tweeted it out, but just replaced the word white with black, and they tried to shut her Twitter page down.
Right, Candace Owens, that's right.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, that's that kind of stuff right there, that's what I'm talking about when I say hypocrisy. And why is it now, all of a sudden, white people, we're supposed to be throwing insults and snarls at white people, when black people, you know, when it was dead to us, we didn't like that. So why is it okay now that white people are being deemed as, those are the racists, so now I can call you names. I can say whatever I want to now about a white person. I can put them in a box, have them quivering in a corner. Mm-hmm. What is that about? And these social media platforms aren't doing anything about it. But as soon as you say the same thing about a black person, now you've lost your whole career. Now they don't want to shut your stuff down. What is that about? It should be equal across the board. I thought we were Americans.
Yeah, you're...
We're Americans. All of us bleed the same. None of us should be throwing that type of hatred towards each other.
That's right.
You are listening to Diamond and Silk on the Larry O'Connor Show. And if you want to follow what they do and see some of their great work, where do you want people to go? What do you prefer? Do you prefer people hook you up on YouTube? Do you prefer them watch you on Facebook? What is your preferred method of delivery?
Go to our website, diamondandsilk.com. We have our chit chat tour. We have our movie coming out, Dummycrats.
That's right. Oh, speaking of that, what are the dates of Dummycrats? Because we got to get something going here.
Be released this fall, you all.
This fall.
But it's about, you know, we know the president is draining the swamp. What we're trying to do is expose the swamp. We're going to expose the hypocrisy.
Mm-hmm.
But what they do, what they don't do. But these people that's been in office for 20-some years and haven't done not one thing, they're working for their own greed and not the need of people. We're going to expose that.
So make sure you go to dummycratsthemovie.com. Put in your email address so you can stay updated and informed.
Yeah, we got to do something here in D.C. with Dummycrats. We got to do the whole red carpet movie premiere and stuff.
It's going to be a red carpet somewhere, I don't know.
Right.
But it's going to be a red carpet somewhere. Right. I just don't know where.
All right. Diamond is going to stay with us because I got to ask you about LeBron James and Don Lemon and that whole ugly scene. And meanwhile, I'm going to diamondandsilk.com right now so I can buy some swag. They got all the things. You got more swag than my show has. Why is that? Do we have anybody in our promotions department? Good Lord. Look at this stuff. You got everything. All right. We're going to continue with Diamond and Silk in a moment. It's 414 on WMAL.
Washington's Mall, WMAL, where Washington comes to talk.
We are speaking with Diamond and Silk. Find out everything you need to know about them at diamondandsilk.com. And yes, they got a movie coming out, Dummycrats, it's called. And boy, do I look forward to seeing that. Ladies, what did you make of this brouhaha about LeBron James coming out criticizing the president? This isn't his first time, by the way. Was it right for the president to take to Twitter, though? Should he have meddled in this whole thing? Because who's watching? Who is watching Don Lemon on CNN talk to LeBron James over the weekend? No one would have even noticed this thing.
Well, really, people that look at the very fake news is who was watching. And yes, the president should have said what he said. Here's the deal. Our president doesn't insult anyone. What he does is he responds to the nasty insults coming from the left. Okay? So he don't have a problem with getting you straight. They starts it, and he finishes, is what happened. And see, LeBron King James, LeBron Burger King James, I call him, Burger King LeBron James, he want to sit, and he want to throw daggers at a sitting president. He want to disrespect the Oval Office. He want to say nasty things about him. And then as soon as the president responds, everybody want to get all upset. No, it don't work that way. You don't get to throw insults at our sitting president and think he's not going to respond.
That's
now,
right.
We know that our president is not the traditional career politician. He's a businessman.
Mm-hmm.
So you're dealing with somebody totally different, and you're dealing with somebody that ain't going to put up and take your mess.
That's right. And LeBron, he's somebody that we call like the gatekeeper of the Democrat plantation. He's trying his best to keep as many people, black people, stuck in that thinking mindset.
Mm-hmm.
That's what he wants to see. He don't want to see anybody come out of that black box, because if you do, then another one is gone. So he's like the gatekeeper of the Democrat plantation.
And can I just say this here? I know we don't have a lot of time.
You have all the time you want, Diamond.
Up a school, and kudos that he's opening up a school.
Mm-hmm.
But now I'm concerned about the children that's going to be going to that school. Are you going to teach them to disrespect the flag? Are you going to be teaching these children to disrespect the Oval Office?
Mm-hmm.
Are you going to be teaching these children to disrespect our country? So now I'm having a problem with, you know, who going to be teaching these children? children.
That's
and
right.
What are you going to be telling these children? Because we live in one of the greatest countries on earth, the greatest country on earth. That's what you need to make sure you're teaching them.
And not to mention, he's not even man enough to sit down and talk with the president of the United States. He's like a scared wimp.
You know what? While we're talking about this school, thank you for delving into this, Diamond and Soap, because no one's saying this. Listen, I think it's great that LeBron James is using his money to open this school for these underprivileged kids. I got a better question. Why isn't the government providing good schools for these kids? Why doesn't LeBron James stand up and say, hold on a minute, we've all been paying taxes in these major cities around this country, all run by Democrats, infiltrated into the school systems, the teachers' union is all run by Democrats. Why do we even need this school? Shouldn't the government be doing this?
Imagine if he got his head out of his backside. Then maybe he can come sit down and talk to the president of the United States of America to help get these schools implemented in these different impoverished areas.
So we don't need a multimillionaire basketball player to pay for one school. One other very important question about LeBron James. What's the deal with that beard? Do you have a name for that kind of beard? Have you ever seen a beard like that before? It's a weird beard.
You know, he disgusts me so much. Because of the rhetoric that comes out of his mouth, I don't even look at him. I didn't even notice he had a beard.
Oh, you got to see this beard. You got to watch the beard, and it's something else. One other thing, I don't know if you saw this poll. It just came out right now. President Trump's approval rating with African Americans is 21%, and I know that's not great, but it's a heck of a lot better than Election Day. I mean, that's more than double.
Well,
what's that all about?
29%. What did it drop? What, somebody's not telling the truth?
We heard it was at 29%. Listen, this is all the president.
Mm-hmm.
I give credit to him because, first of all, what he did was brought back economic opportunity.
That's right.
Is what he did. He took and he paved the way. So you know what? I'm going to bring some jobs back over here. You all are going to be able to work. Even if you look at food stamps, people are jumping off the food stamps. I don't want that no more. Mm-hmm. He's taking us from poverty to prosperity, from welfare to the workforce, and black people are happy about that. And it's just not at 29%. That's what the Paul's saying, but you don't know what they're chattering about out here in the streets,
that's
in the
right.
hood. People love this president.
And President Trump have done more for the black community in less than 2 years than Obama did in 8 years. Obama is biracial, and his black side didn't even do nothing for the black community.
That's
and
right.
Then he want to build a $200 million library in Chicago, and people are not even living long enough to read a book.
That's right. He better build him a little bookmobile and get him a little truck, call it a bookmobile and call it a day and say that's the library.
Thank you, ladies. It's always good to talk to you, and you always make me smile. Diamond and Silk.
You okay?
I am good. I just wasn't expecting the bookmobile part. Diamondandsilk.com. Ladies, always good to talk to you. Keep up the great work.
Thank you for having me.